All right, continuing, we're going to look at how to order real numbers. All real numbers, not just rational numbers, but all real numbers. So let's see how to do that. So they're given any two real numbers, either they are equal to each other or one is bigger than the other. This is called the trichotomy property of real numbers. So this property allows us to order numbers from smallest to largest or largest to smallest. So ascending or descending order. Descending means you're going from largest to smallest. Ascending, that means you're going from smallest to largest. All right, so let's say I want to order these decimal numbers. All right, so if you want to order decimal numbers, the first thing is to get them all to have equal number of digits. So if you look right now, 45.69 and 3.4, they do not have the same number of digits. So in all the missing place values, you insert zeros so that they all have four digits, because that's the largest number of digits across the numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So anywhere that I was missing a digit, I inserted a zero in its place. So now look, 4, 0, 2, and 0. So clearly, 0 is smaller than 2, right? So these two numbers would have to be switched. All right, so let's do that. So you start with the largest place value. So the largest place value in our case is the tens place, right? So we start with the tens place and you look at the largest number in the tens place. So 4, 0, 2, 0. 4 is in the largest place, so that needs to stay up here. But here we have 0, here we have a 2, so these two numbers should switch. All right, so let's do that. All right, once you've done that, now we have 4, 2, 0, 0. All right, but now we need to look at the next digit. Clearly, this number is on top because it does not share digits with anybody else, the tens place digit. So now we look at 2. 2 is in the tens place here, so that also stays here. It does not share it with anybody else, and it's the largest among those. But here we have 0, 0. If the highest place value digits match, that means they are equal, then you have to look at the next. So here's the next digit in the units place or ones place. We have the units place here is 3, the units place here is 3. They match, so we can't really do anything there. Let's look at the tenths place. They both share a 4 in the tenths place. So you keep on comparing them until you have aligned all your numbers the way you want them. Let's look at the next digit. Okay, here they are different. So in the 100s place, here we have a 0, here we have a 9, right? A 0, 9. So 9 is bigger than 0, so we need to switch those. So switching those will give you that. Now there are no more digits or numbers to compare, so now we have our numbers from highest to lowest. So take a look. Oops. So take a look. Our numbers then are going to be 45.69, 23.4, 3.49, 3.4. Highest to lowest. All right? So you keep, make sure, what did we just do? I'm just repeating the steps so you understand. All the digits should have something in them. So if their digit is missing in a place value, you add 0 in it. So all numbers have equal place values. Then you start comparing from the leftmost digit, which is the highest place value, and you start comparing and then start arranging them. All right, let's take another example. What if they are not written in decimal form? They are written in fraction form. Well, now that we know how to make equivalent fractions, we will make equivalent fractions for all four of the numbers that we have. So we have a 3 and a 5, so 15 will be the common denominator. You can choose any number, it doesn't have to be 5, just so that they all have the same denominator. So you have 10 15ths, 9 15ths, negative 12 15ths, negative 5 15ths. And this time, we want to arrange them in ascending order, so lowest to highest. So our numbers written with common denominators are like this. Now, take a look. So when we write our numbers in ascending order, since the denominators are the same, you just have to line up the numerators. So we have negative 12, negative 5, 9, and 10. And that's how it's going to look then. You can see negative 12 is less than negative 5. Why is that? Because owing somebody $12 is worse than owing somebody just $5, right? So when you think of negative numbers, you can think of them as debt or owing something. That will allow you to order them properly. All right, let's see if you can do that. Do the same process like we did in the first example. I'll give you a few moments. So pause the video here and see what you can do. Are you pausing? All right, assuming you've paused and come back. So we put zeros in the places where necessary and then order them. Negative 4 should go at the bottom. So that will be my first number. So let's do that. And then we have everything in order. All right, so then let's take a look at the next digit. So the only two numbers, these two are already in place, but these two shared a 2 in the first digit, so we have to keep comparing them until they differ. So here they differ. We have a 0 here and a 3 here, and so what do you think? So it's already in order, right? Good. We don't have to do anything. Here's your next set of video log questions. This number here is 10,012. So we have 9,987. Here's your next set of video log questions. This first row is 9,987, 10,012, 8,999. In case it was unclear. In case it was unclear.